Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant and YouTuber. And in this Canva tutorial, you're going to learn how to quickly put together a thumbnail for your YouTube videos, timestamp table contents in the description, along with some other videos to building PDFs and presentations with Canva. With that, let's go ahead and jump right in. The very first step, of course, is having a picture of yourself. Now, I went ahead and took a bunch of pictures before I started recording. And to save some time, I've gone ahead and chosen one. So typically what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to have yourself on the right-hand side of the screen so you can put text on the left-hand side. So what that means is if you want to be on the right for your picture, when you're looking at the camera, you want to be over on the left because the text is going to go up here. So you definitely don't want to go to the right and then realize that the text, you put a bunch of space in the opposite place, right? So once you've done that, you have two options. Number one, we can go ahead and just make this our entire background and go ahead and start adding some text on top of it, or we can remove the background and just have ourselves. So I'm gonna go ahead and actually do both. So you can see I just clicked and dragged, made it the full screen as our background, or if we go ahead and duplicate this real quick, we can actually shrink it back down here. I'll go ahead and leave our image library alone for now. And then what you can do is you can come up here to effects and remove background. Now this is going to take a little bit and it might not work. And if it doesn't, that's okay. You can just go with the first method. But after about 30 seconds, you will have, come on, there we go. A background removed picture just like this one. So we're gonna go ahead, you'll want to double click on it and crop it so it's a lot easier to work with. So I'm gonna go ahead and crop it right there and then pull in over here and crop it a little bit on the left-hand side as well. Okay, perfect. So if we wanted, so now that we have ourselves, we can go ahead and click and drag, pull it into the corner, make it nice and big, and then we'd have plenty of space to put text and graphics. For this particular example, I'm just going to come up here because I really actually like backgrounds where it is just text overlaid. So we'll go ahead and do this. We really like doing this for our vlogs. And I'll click and drag over so that I'm making the picture a little bigger, but I'm still giving enough space over on the left for some text. And just like that, we're cropped in. So let's go ahead and add our text elements. And let's say this is a video for some lead magnet ideas, right? We're targeting people who want to grow an email list. So we're gonna lead magnet, there we go. And then we'll go ahead and select all of the text. We can come up here and change the font. You wanna make sure that it's a nice clean font that's very easy to read. And I'll just go ahead and leave it at the default font here. And then we'll go ahead and make this either 72 or higher because we really want it to be very, very easy to read when it gets shrunk down because it's gonna be a lot smaller than what we're looking at here. So let's try 88. I think that's actually, we're actually gonna be able to make that work. So we'll go ahead and hit escape and then we'll click and drag the text over up here. And of course, it's a little hard to read. We're gonna want something behind it. So a quick little hack here is to go over to elements and simply select the square icon and give it a color. So we'll make a little square. We'll put it behind the text. I'll speed up to where I've adjusted it properly. And let's go ahead and change the color. So we can come up here and change the color. Now, something that's cool is if you come down here, photo colors, Canva will actually automatically pick up elements or pick up picture elements. So pick up colors in your photo to help you match. I'm just gonna go with black because that's the easiest one. But as you can see, you can actually click see all and it comes up with a lot of different colors based upon the photos that you have. So I'll go ahead and just leave it at black here, make it nice and easy to read. And then of course, I'm gonna say this is lead magnet ideas. So the easiest way to do this is to click and drag and copy both of them that you have your element and we'll pull it down right here. And then we'll go ahead and change our text to just be ideas and then pull in our little background element there so it's not as large and fits the smaller text. Now, something else you can play with, especially if you have long text and if it goes all the way across and starts going into your face, a cool little hack is actually just tilting the text a little bit and it gets you just a little bit more space. So now we can click and drag and actually make it even bigger. Now I'm selecting both elements right now And so when you select, when you make sure you select both elements, see how I'm selecting that? You'll be able to make them bigger and smaller at the same time as opposed to trying to do it individually. Now I'm gonna put lead magnets and I'm gonna try and center it, lead magnet ideas, and then I will hit escape and click on this element, come up here to position and send it backward. So that way it is behind this lead, and if I click and drag it up, you can see that it's actually behind lead magnet, so it's not gonna get in the way of the A. So I think we're good to go here. And if you wanted to stop here, that's totally fine. This type of thumbnail totally works. When it comes to your thumbnail text, you really have two options. It's either you're just describing what the video is. In this particular instance, it's lead magnet ideas. That's what we're talking about, so that's what people are gonna get when they click. Or you can go the other route, trying to build curiosity. That's a lot harder to do. So for example, with lead magnet ideas, this is something about creating something to help someone grow their email list. So instead of talking about what the actual video is about, we could talk about something that they will be able to do or achieve as a result of watching the video. So instead, we could say grow a massive email list, right? Or lead generation secret or something like that to build a little more curiosity. I like leaving it nice and simple. So up here, we're gonna go ahead and add a couple of graphics. So first, idea means light bulb. I mean, everyone knows light bulb means idea. So I'm just gonna type in light bulb over here. Apparently I search for it, I use this a lot. Now there are a lot of, I have the pro version of Canva, so I have a lot of these to choose from, but there are free ones and you can also filter so you only see the free ones. So if I went ahead and clicked availability, apply the filters, now we're only looking at the free ones. So let's go ahead and choose this one. That one's nice and simple. We could come up here and change the colors. For time purposes, I'm just gonna leave it alone and we're gonna take this bulb, put it right next to ideas, and why don't we make it a little to the side and adjust it just like that. Of course, we could add some other elements if we wanted to, but for now, I think that's good. We definitely don't want to add too many icons and make it too distracting or hard to read. So speaking of reading, let's make sure that it is in fact easy to read. So we'll come down here to zoom and you'll want to click on 25%. We just want to make sure that it's very easy to read the text, whether you're doing basic text like this that's just describing the video, or you're trying to build some curiosity. You want to make sure that it's very easy to read. And now that I'm looking at it smaller, I'm actually going to want to move this light bulb so it doesn't obstruct the text. Now, one of the last things you can do here is we'll go ahead and click on it and we'll click on adjust. And this is where you're going to want to play with the saturation and the contrast. Now, when we blow it back up, it's gonna look bad. It will look bad. But most people are browsing YouTube on their mobile device, and even when they're on desktop, the thumbnails are pretty small. So this is just a quick little way to help the photo pop. So you can see if we up the contrast all the way like that, that doesn't look very great. But if we play with it a little bit, we can see what it is looks like at zero, and then pulling it up a little bit, you can see that, wow, it really, really pops here. So then we can play with the saturation a little bit. I like playing with contrast more than saturation. So I'm just pulling it up and down so you can see what the differences are. And I think something like that, now it looks like I have a tan. So I'm just gonna leave it at 7 and call that good. And so really that's all there is to it, to putting together great looking thumbnails with Canva. And of course, you'll definitely want to figure out your own style and play with different things. The only other thing I can say is make sure when you're taking your pictures for your thumbnails that you take a lot of pictures. And I mean way more than you think you need. Simply just with your camera settings, set it to automatically take a picture every 5 seconds and then just keep going through different poses, and one of them will come out good. So it's pretty much like throwing spaghetti at the wall. Just try a bunch, 20 to 30 at least, and then one will look decent enough where you're not gonna be too critical of yourself. So thank you so much for watching. I sincerely hope you got some value out of this video. And most importantly, you feel a lot more confident putting together quick thumbnails with Canva. Make sure you check out the links in the description to other Canva tutorials on how to put together lead magnets, ironically, or PDFs, ebooks, and of course, presentations and some other graphics for your social media and channel. So go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe for more tutorials just like this one, and until the next, keep building the business you love.